At least we both know that we're still okay. We're still okay, right?
Yes.
I want you to be tough and fight to the end, for both of us. I'll be watching and cheering for you back home.
Hello, everybody. I'm cocoa.cosmos, and today I'll be talking about the beloved total drama couple that used to be Gwen and Trent. At first sight, they've taken a bit of a liking to each other, and they would be close, even if Gwen wanted to pretend it's not so. They're super into each other, even if the other isn't sure about that. Conversations are usually easy, as they're two of the more level-headed contestants on their team. On Gwen's end, she gets shy about her crush and publicly denies it, while very obviously having a crush on Trent. When her diary gets taken and Heather reads it out publicly, it's clear who she's talking about. On Trent's end, it's no secret. He pays her many compliments in his confessionals. He wrote a whole song for her. They're usually seen together as they're on the same team, and on Gwen's end, one of the only people they can tolerate. Their most significant bonding session happened during the No Sleep Challenge, where they tried to keep each other awake. This is honestly one of my favorite Gwen moments because it really shows their compatibility and how naturally they get along. This really was, or could have been, a best friend to lovers relationship. Everything seemed to flow easily. Trent helps her during the key challenge. Gwen fears the skunk protecting her key, and Trent offers the solution of pouring water down the skunk hole. Gwen and Trent both do confessionals, professing their heavy liking for each other.
That was moderately cool of Trent to help me avoid the skunks. He's okay. Okay. He's more than okay. He's so incredible. But don't tell anyone I said that.
The fact that Gwen is so smart and independent, coupled with the fact that she's incredible to look at, is just making me nuts. She rocks my world. So yeah, I'll take a skunk shot for her any day.
Then they share a kiss. Their first kiss. After spying on Gwen and Trent and seeing them kiss, Heather decides that she has to take matters into her own hands. She enlists Lindsay in her scheme to trick the couple into thinking the other dislikes them. Gwen receives a letter from Trent to meet him at the dock. When she gets there, she sees Trent and Heather kissing. Heartbroken, she runs off in tears. On Trent's end, Lindsay points out that Heather's crying and suggests that he go talk to her. When he does, she claims that Gwen has said horrible things about him and that she's using him. When Heather gets the signal that Gwen is coming, she kisses him. It's all very dramatic, but what else do you expect from a show called Total Drama? Trent ends up eliminated due to Heather's manipulation, but Gwen and Trent get back on track. At the Total Drama Island finale, Trent follows Gwen around the race just to talk to her. You'd think that he was a finalist. Gwen lets him know that she's not mad at him, but currently doesn't trust him. As a last resort, he carries a big rock while running beside her to show his loyalty. At the end of the race, she agrees to go out with him, in both endings.
Okay, I'll go out with you! Shut up already! Yes, I'll go out with you!
Oh lord, here we go. I went over a good chunk of it in my Gwen analysis video and in my 5 characters who deserve better video. If you haven't watched them and you want to, go check them out. Trent's character got wrecked for real. Like, look at this face. It's not natural. So, I'm gonna try to condense it. Trent gets all weird about Gwen and Duncan's friendship, making him insecure. So, going from trying to make Gwen jealous, to using his lucky number obsessively, to even throwing challenges for her, he's trying to do everything in his power to ensure that Gwen still likes him. Gwen naturally gets a bit weirded out, but still gives him the reassurance he needs until the throwing challenges part. She gets annoyed by this, because she wants to win fair and square. Which leads to this next thing. After losing the cattle wrangling challenge, Trent takes an average shower because he feels he's been embarrassed enough. Gwen meets him there and talks about his recent behavior, pointing out that being a bit weird was okay, but he can't be throwing challenges for her. She then breaks up with him, and Trent takes it pretty well. That's until elimination, where he's carried out because he refused to leave before he said goodbye to Gwen. Trent discovers Gwen threw him under the bus during the aftermath show. He didn't take it well. He's shown sobbing every time the backstage cameras goes live with him, even freestyling a song about the betrayal. When he comes out on stage, though, he clears everything up, even telling us where his nine obsession comes from. When Gwen gets her turn on the show, she receives a pretty cool welcome. Primarily because of the breakup, but also because of the suspect behavior between her and Duncan. She reiterates that they're just friends. Eventually, Gwen and Trent become cool again. You know, after Gwen gets together with Duncan during world tour. Gwen and Trent were so good together. I wish the writers didn't have to ruin Trent's character so badly to make Gwuncan happen. And the fact that they weren't gonna put Gwuncan together in the first place, but Cartoon Network wanted them together. So the only way for it to make sense is by making Trent incredibly undateable. At least Trent went back to normal after a while, though we don't see him compete anymore. On the compatibility scale, before Trent lost his mind, I give them a 9, but for action, I bump it down to 7.5. How do you feel about Gwen? Think there are better ships to talk about? Let me know in the comments below. Cocoa Cosmos, out.